Hi, I'm meteorologist Ross Whitley. Looking at our current dew points out there, and if you remember 24 hours ago, we were in the category. It was steamy, nasty out there, but now our dew points are actually pretty close to that comfortable range. And while we're still in the muggy category, we will be seeing temperatures drop back down into the lower 60s overnight tonight. So another cool night, but unfortunately, things all change tomorrow as our winds will change from out of the northeast where they've been today to out of the southwest, and that's going to be bringing back the humidity and the warmer temperatures. Looking at a radar and satellite, all is clear. You can't even tell that this thing is in motion other than some higher clouds showing up just off to our north, and you can see a tiny little shower in Alabama and the Florida Panhandle down there, but around our area, all is clear and likely to stay that way as we go throughout the rest of tonight. Should allow that heat to radiate on out and for a cool, crisp morning tomorrow as you wake up. Then throughout the day, mostly sunny and very, very warm as the temperatures will be warming back up into the upper 80s. As we go into Saturday, our forecast high is 90 degrees. The record back in 1953, 91. So very, very close to that record. We'll be right at it, if not breaking it, could even tie it going throughout the day on Saturday. Our surface map for tomorrow, humid air suppressed still to our south, but you notice the direction out of the southwest, and that's where our winds will be coming from as well. High pressure system basically set up over Jackson, Tennessee, and that's where it will be still influencing our weather as much as the aloft area in the atmosphere is dry, so we're not going to have any showers or storms or really even clouds to deal with. But at the surface, things will start to moisten up. And as we go into Saturday ahead of a cold front, we're really going to be very, very warm. And that's the pattern. That's what we see trending. The good news is we've had this huge trough in the west, and that brings a big ridge in the east. Well, going into next week, this levels out. So this jet stream being zonal or west to east, that allows for cooler air to slide underneath and kind of get trapped. So as that happens, that's going to allow for more dry, cool weather throughout the week. Instead of all of that warm air surging from the south, we're going to have cooler air drifting southward from the north. That means very nice temperatures for us. 58 overnight tonight, clear skies, winds out of the northeast at about 5 to 10 miles per hour. For the day tomorrow, we'll start off with the winds out of the northeast at 5, maybe around 10. We'll warm up to near 90 degrees once again. Plenty of sunshine throughout the day, but check out this extended forecast. And yes, I'm very excited about it if you can't tell. 74 for next Monday, 74 on Tuesday, 72 next Wednesday. We do warm up as we get into the end of next week ahead of another cold front, but the dew points will be down in the 50s, even the 40s potentially, as far as our dew points go. That's very, very dry for this time of year. And hey, you know what? We've been dealing with the opposite end.
Yeah.
We'll take a little below average and lower dew points, or at least I will.
Yeah.
I love this type of weather.
A little break.
Jacket.
I know. We're not the biggest fans of jacket wearing weather, but.
Yeah, maybe in the morning, something you can kind of shed in the afternoon, because we'll still be in the mid 70s by the afternoon. It's going to be feeling perfect.
With sunshine, that feels great.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
We'll take it.
Thanks, Ross.